Trump's attack on Mika Brzezinski draws rebukes across a fractious media. President Trump's extraordinary attack on the television host Mika Brzezinski on Thursday capped a week of mounting acrimony between the White House and the press. But at a moment when the news media is increasingly fractured, the personal and crude nature of Mr. Trump's Twitter remarks about Ms. Brzezinski, the co-host of MSNBC's Morning Joe, proved to be an equal opportunity stunner, sparking a backlash that spanned the news industry's usual divides. Shortly before 9 a.m., Mr. Trump taunted Ms. Brzezinski and her co-host and fiancé, Joe Scarborough, as low-IQ crazy Mika, along with Psycho Joe, and described a meeting with Ms. Brzezinski in which, the president claimed, she was bleeding badly from a facelift. The coarseness of his remark, which echoed previous instances in which the president attacked prominent women, including the anchor Megyn Kelly and the Republican presidential candidate Carly Fiorina, about their physical appearance drew rebukes even within the bulwarks of the Trump-friendly news media. Is that necessary? Asked the Fox News anchor Bill Hemmer, referring to the graphic nature of Mr. Trump's comments, as Sarah Huckabee Sanders, the deputy White House press secretary, argued that Mr. Trump's harsh words were justified. Britium, the veteran Fox News analyst, called it absurd that a president could feel bullied by hosts of a cable news show. I love sick burns on Twitter, but I'm not president of the United States, the Republican Fox News host Kennedy said during an on-air discussion in which former Governor Mike Huckabee of Arkansas, Ms. Sanders' father, allowed that the president's words might have been ill-considered. For Mr. Trump's inner circle, however, the outburst was no surprise. An avid television viewer, the president has fumed for weeks about the coverage on Morning Joe using the psycho moniker in private to describe Mr. Scarborough as the co-hosts became increasingly acidic in their commentary, according to a senior administration official. Minutes before Mr. Trump's tweets Thursday, Ms. Brzezinski derided the president as lying every day and destroying the country. Mr. Trump has been particularly upset by the host's questioning of his mental state, the official said, viewing it as a form of personal betrayal. Mr. Trump and the Morning Joe duo once enjoyed a relatively friendly relationship. Mr. Scarborough and Ms. Brzezinski visited Mr. Trump's Florida estate, Mar-a-Lago, this past New Year's. Privately, Ms. Brzezinski was stunned by the remarks, telling a close friend on Thursday morning, "I really don't need this." Her father, Zbigniew Brzezinski, a former national security advisor, died in May, and her mother, Emily Benice Brzezinski, has suffered two heart attacks since he died, according to the friend, who requested anonymity to describe a private conversation. Ms. Brzezinski was expected to address the incident on air Friday morning. For now, her only public comment has been a photograph she posted to Twitter of a box of Cheerios, emblazoned with the words, "Mad for little hands," referring to a long-standing insult about Mr. Trump. CNN, one of MSNBC's chief rivals, issued a statement in support of Ms. Brzezinski, a rare sign of solidarity in the famously fractious TV news world. The message spoke to a growing sense among journalists that they must unite against the anti-press barrage from Mr. Trump and his aides, particularly after a week where Ms. Sanders, at the White House lectern, encouraged Americans to watch an anti-CNN video, whether it's accurate or not. At her televised briefing Thursday, Ms. Sanders faced tough questions about the tweets from numerous outlets, including two journalists for Fox News, John Roberts and John Decker, who post some of the session's more pointed queries. "The only person that I see a war on is this president and everybody that works for him," Ms. Sanders said, echoing her comments earlier this week that Americans deserve something better from the news media. "I don't think you can expect someone to be personally attacked day after day, minute by minute, and sit back," Ms. Sanders told the journalists. "The American people elected a fighter. They didn't elect somebody to sit back and do nothing. They knew what they were getting when they voted for Donald Trump." The desire to punch back has fueled several of the president's media feuds, including his ongoing clash with CNN, whose president, Jeffrey A. Zucker, hired him to host The Apprentice at NBC. The president has bragged to friends that he secured Mr. Zucker's current job by recommending him to a top executive at Turner, CNN's parent company, People familiar with CNN's hiring process have said Mr. Trump's endorsement did not play a role. A retraction by CNN this week of a report about one of Mr. Trump's associates followed by the resignations of three CNN journalists who worked on the story had buoyed Mr. Trump and his team. The president gloated about the network's mishap and cited the retraction as evidence that the establishment news media was biased against him. Some precincts of the right-leaning news media, such as Breitbart News, refrained from criticizing Mr. Trump, playing down the story of the president's remarks. But other Trump-friendly journalists took exception. Shortly after the president's tweets, Trey Yingst, White House correspondent for the conservative-leaning One America News Network, wrote on Twitter, "It costs nothing to be kind." One of Mr. Trump's most stalwart defenders, Sean Hannity of Fox News, at first suggested that Mr. Scarborough deserved the opprobrium for calling the president a liar, a thug and mentally unhinged, Mr. Hannity wrote. By Thursday afternoon, on his syndicated radio show, Mr. Hannity had softened his view. He said that it would have been in Mr. Trump's best interest not to do it, in my humble opinion, referring to the remarks.